Good evening, everyone. I, Dr. Sachin Doshi, an orthodontist, would like to give you a small talk on surgical orthodontics. Now, everyone knows orthodontia or orthodontics is putting braces and getting the teeth into alignment. But just wanted to make you aware that all the problems of your teeth cannot just be corrected by only the braces. Some cases have skeletal, that is the jaw problem, the upper jaw as well as the lower jaw. Some cases might have a combination of problem of the jaws, or some cases might have a problem with the individual jaws. So only alignment of the teeth may or may not suffice the skeletal discrepancies. Normally people have a class 1 jaw. Let us try to understand what is a class 1 jaw, wherein the upper jaw and the lower jaw are almost of the same size and they compensate for the position of the teeth. But in some cases, there is a certain thing known as a class 2 or a class 3. Let us focus on class 2. Class 2 is considered when the patient has the upper jaw which is very ahead as compared to the lower jaw, and the teeth will be in this position. Suppose these are the upper teeth and these are the lower teeth. So this much amount of dental correction by taking the teeth back becomes almost impossible by dental movements. So in these cases, we have to go in for the correction of the jaw. Correction of the jaw has two different sets depending on the age at which the patient comes to our dental operatory. If the patient is a young adult, correction of the dental problems along with the skeletal problems can be done with certain extraoral appliances, wherein a certain strap would be placed on the head with the extraoral wire and patient has to put it every day for at least 16 to 18 hours. But as patients might be adults and the growth is already finished, so in those cases, these extraoral appliances will not correct the existing skeletal problem. In these cases, we will need a help of oral surgeon who will deal with the correction of the jaw problems by putting the patient under general anesthesia and correcting the jaw excess or deficiency or anterior or posterior positioning by cutting the jaw and reducing or increasing the length of the jaw. This is known as a Lefort 1 operation or Lefort 1 surgery if we are doing for the upper jaw. Similarly, patients might have a problem with the lower jaw where the lower jaw will be back. Okay, so in those cases, we need to advance or take the lower jaw ahead. Since the growth or the increase in the length of the mandible or the lower jaw has stopped because the patient is an adult, so in these cases, cutting the jaw and taking it ahead becomes a good option. Similarly, we have to put you across that these are all intraoral procedures and there would be no scarring seen on your face post surgery. Few days of discomfort would be there and then patient will be fine. Welcome back. Let us continue with what we were discussing as the surgery for the lower jaw. This was these both options, the Lefort 1 and the mandibular advancement was or were for the correction of the class 2 because of maxilla ahead or mandible deficiency or a combination of both. Let us talk of class 3, wherein the lower jaw is ahead of the upper jaw or the upper jaw is back of the lower jaw. In these cases, or a combination, both the combination as well as individual jaw problems would require individual or bi-jaw surgery, as it is exactly opposite of what we treated for the class 2, wherein you have to advance the maxilla in this case and take the mandible or take the lower jaw behind. These are all major surgical procedures. Let us talk or focus on certain thing known as minor surgical procedures. See, there are individuals who even after the correction of the dental problems are not satisfied, as in they say that my teeth have gone too back, or my chin is a little more prominent, or my nose is jutting out, and when the teeth are in alignment, I see when I enter the room, my nose comes first and then I enter the room. So for them, different plastic surgical options known as the rhinoplasty or genioplasty, where you can alter the size and the shape of your chin or alter the size and shape of your nose, can be done. Similarly, as we have different race of patients wherein the thickness of the lip vary. Certain people like the Europeans have thin lips. Certain people of Indian descent have thick lips. So these thicknesses of the lip also play a major role in the support. What happens if you take too much teeth back? If there are thin lips, they'll just fall back and there would be no support. So people with thin lips can afford a little amount of proclined teeth because the lip will still have support. As against people with having thick lips, if the teeth go back, still the amount of lip falling would not be that much. Surgical aspects can include some amount of intraoral correction procedures wherein aesthetics can be improved along with the help of an oral surgeon or a periodontist and an orthodontist, wherein when the patients smile, good amount of gums are seen. So patients are not happy. When I smile, there's good amount of gums in. I don't want that display. So minor intraoral aesthetic periodontal surgical procedures wherein small amount of gum can be cut and lengthening of the crown can be done. So when the patient smiles, the length of the crown is increased and the visibility of gums is also reduced. Similarly, a small but a very important surgical correction would be the lip length. Not all people have lip length which are compensatory or parallel to your existing jaw sizes, especially the upper lip. If the upper lip is short and when the patient is smiling, more amount of gums are seen. To correct that, certain amount of lengthening of the tooth can be done, but we cannot increase the length to a great extent. So similarly, in these cases, a minor lip lengthening procedure can be done by a oral or a plastic surgeon. You want me to you want me to continue or there is a time left?
Yeah, you have one minute.
I thought I did not see your leg. Now, minor surgical procedures also can include the correction of frenal attachment. Sometimes patients have gaps between your two central teeth, and that gap is because of the small attachment of frenum. This small soft tissue is known as frenum, wherein it goes between two teeth. And now you imagine, if I have two teeth and I have put in something between them, if I want them that to be closed, this thing has to be removed. This is known as removal of the frenum. So small amount of frenum removal can help remove the barrier and help achieve the closure of the midline diastema. Surgical procedures which are included under minor surgical category shall also include cases wherein the teeth are not coming out of their gums because of the increased thickness of the gum or because of certain amount of bony obstruction. So a minor surgical procedure, after giving a limited amount of local anesthesia to the patient, will numb that area. A small cut with a knife will help us achieve opening for the tooth to come in the desired position, and along with orthodontics, the tooth can be taken into alignment and the problem of impacted teeth can be solved to a great extent. So to sum up the surgical cases, let us not be afraid of those major surgery what people have been focusing on the internet. No, it was very painful, it was very difficult. In my suggestion and a suggestion to everyone sitting across is that if the surgical corrections are required, let us be in for it. Let us bear the pain for a certain amount of days because it will help you for a lifelong correction of the skeletal and dental problems. Thank you.